Hi, and welcome back to the Save It For Parts channel. In the past, I've done a number of different kinds of potato cannons, and today, I'm going to try to make yet another potato gun using this beat-up, maybe-working nail gun that I found in a dumpster. I figure this is a pretty cool platform for some kind of pneumatic potato cannon, because it already has the trigger, the air system, the hookup for an air compressor. So first off, let's see if this thing even works. Alright, I've got the garage compressor aired up, and let's see if it'll go. Yeah, that goes. Okay, so that was terrifying. Let's take this thing apart and see what makes it go. There's the piston that goes out, and there goes the piston head. Honestly, this looks really easy to modify if I just leave the piston out, use that as my air chamber, and then maybe drill this out a little more so that I can adapt in a PVC fitting. Then I can just put in whatever PVC barrel I want onto this thing. Oh yeah, this is really professional. Only the most high precision machining is done here on the Save It For Parts channel. Quality. This might be the easiest potato gun I've ever made. Well, I had a golf pencil in there as ammo, but who knows where it went. So this thing works pretty well. Let's improve it some more. I don't remember where I got these ball bearings, but they are just about the perfect size for this. Alrighty, so what I have here is a pump action. We load our ball bearings in the top, pump it back, they drop into the barrel, run into this bolt where the ball bearing is stopped from rolling farther back, pump forward to seal it, and hang on a second. I'm gonna need a little more safety for this one. All right, here we go. Okay, that went through my target box and may have slightly destroyed something behind it. Alright, so this thing is a lot of fun, but it's still tethered to my garage where the air compressor lives. Or is it? I found this in the trash as well. It's supposed to be some kind of a sandblaster or soda blaster, but I could never get it to work right with baking soda. So right now it's basically just a big air tank. I also have a ton of these cast-off backpacks. These were also being thrown out. They still have the price tags on them and everything. They smell terrible. They smell like decomposing plastic. I'm gonna try to modify this backpack to hold my air tank. I feel like I'm ready to bust ghosts or something. I think I found my ball bearing. Okay, so it turns out it's incredibly easy to make a potato cannon, or in this case a ball bearing cannon, out of an old nail gun. Should you do this? No, this thing is terrifying. Don't try this at home. None of this is really held in with any kind of glue, it's just sort of there. So at any point this could fly apart, or a ball bearing could come back and hit me in the face. and I would not recommend doing this. I'm going to set this one aside because I'm honestly a little scared of it, and maybe we'll come back to it in the future, but for now it's just going to go on the wall with the rest of my silly potato gun projects. So thanks for watching, and check out my other videos if you want to see other potato gun projects, and we'll see you next time. Thank you.